Blackstone Publishing presents Come and Get These Memories, The Genius of Holland-Dozier-Holland, Motown's Incomparable Songwriters, by Eddie and Brian Holland, with Dave Thompson. This book is read by Kevin Kenerly and Rodney Gardiner.
Dedications. Brian, I want to dedicate our book to my wife, Cassandra, also my children, Linda, Letitia, Holly, Brian Jr., and Brandon.
Eddie, I want to dedicate our book to my children, Edward, David, Eric, Christina, Edina, Craig, and Lauren, hoping it will give them a deeper insight and understanding into my life. Also, to my nephew, Johnny Terry, who is more of a son to me, and his wife, Isella. To Maggie Jones, whose inspiration stimulated the insight that caused me to look deeper. To Richard Davis, for holding down the fort and taking care of the accountants, CPS, and lawyers, and giving me time to concentrate on this book. To Barney Ailes, for so many memories and a lovely introduction to this book. To Bishop Andrew Merritt of the Straight Gate International Church, whose wisdom and guidance gave me so much inspiration. And very special thanks to Shirley Washington for so aggressively and consistently pushing me to complete this book, no matter what else I wanted to do, to go deep into myself, even when I didn't feel like it, and for arousing memories that I really didn't want to contact. Without her, this book would never have been written. Most people would have turned away, but Shirley endured my insults and rage and always moved ahead. Shirley, meanwhile, would like to offer special thanks to her research team, Gwendolyn Owens and Marion Michaels, and to our agent, Lee Sobel. Dave Thompson. Thanks to my agent, Lee Sobel, for making it happen, to Shirley Washington for so much more, and to Amy Hansen for everything else. Thanks to Barney Ailes for his masterful memoir, Motown, The Sound of Young America, Tams and Hudson, 2018. Thanks also to Joanne Green, Karen and Todd, Jen, Oliver, Trevor, and sundry snails and fish. A problem is no bigger or smaller than the mind sees it to be. People cannot create problems for you. They can only create obstacles. You must create the problem in your own mind. Eddie Holland.
Foreword by Barney Ailes. I first met Eddie and Brian Holland at the bowling alley on Woodward Avenue in Detroit. They were kids at the time. Brian was maybe 17. Eddie was a couple of years older, and they were still at the dawn of their musical careers. Whereas I, at the grand old age of 26, was already running a record distributing company. I liked them both immediately, and my interest was further piqued when I got to see Eddie perform. Like I said, he was still just starting out, a slow stream of solo singles recorded with Berry Gordy as the still nascent Motown operation came to life. But he could sing. He was a natural, the sexiest, slickest thing on two legs. The girls went wild for him. He sounded to me like Jackie Wilson, and a lot of other people agreed. He was a reluctant performer, though. He loathed touring, hated performing. He disliked travel. He didn't enjoy crowds. We were together a lot, going from gig to gig, record hop to radio station, and he never ever caused me any problems. Always a gentleman, always doing his best to help. He was really good about everything. I knew he wasn't happy with the life he was leading, but he never allowed it to affect his work. He was professional through and through. And I could tell there was more to him than just a great singer and performer. I remember one time we were in San Francisco, getting ready for a performance at the Cow Palace alongside the Marvelettes. The only problem was, finances were tight, and we were only able to bring one Marvelette with us, Gladys. The idea was, we would recruit four more girls once we got into town, and they would stand in for the rest of the group. Eddie took charge, arranging the auditions, listening to the girls who filed into the room, and putting together a group for the show. He wasn't even fazed when we realized we didn't have...
We hope you enjoyed this preview. To continue listening to this audiobook on Google Play Books, use the link in the video description.